In this video, we are going to talk about how to create your own crypto within 10 minutes and with just a couple of dollars. The process is easy and requires no knowledge of programming. Before we start, I would like to share some basic aspects of crypto, and I would also like to urge you to use this knowledge for good and not scams or rug pull projects. Try to create something valuable instead. Let's start. The first thing we need to understand is that we are going to be creating a token, which can have the same purposes as any crypto on the market. Often people use the term coin when referring to tokens, in which case the token is considered a digital asset and can be processed as a payment. In fact, you might know some high market cap tokens that people call coins, such as Uniswap, PancakeSwap, and Axie Infinity. However, at their core, there are differences between tokens and coins. Coins live on their own native blockchains and are the main currency of their networks. Tokens live on existing blockchain networks and don't have their own. It's much harder to create a new coin than it is token, as you need to create your own blockchain network and find miners. In this video, we are creating a token from scratch while spending little time and money on it. The first step is to choose a blockchain network. There are two networks I personally prefer: Ethereum network, on which we can create ERC20 token, and BSC network, where we can create BEP20 token. We will be using BSC network to create our token today. The gas fee over there is currently cheaper. Binance Smart Chain is basically a copy of Ethereum blockchain network, with the exception of logic and minor details. Therefore, we'll be relying on the same knowledge, tools, and language as if we were creating a token on Ethereum network. The tools in question are Remix website, necessary to edit the code, and MetaMask wallet. And the programming language we will be using is Solidity. There are two ways when it comes to creating a token. The easiest one is to use third-party platforms like vitominacore.github and cointool.app. This will cost you around $300, but we want to go the cheapest and the easiest route, right? That is why we will be using the actual template for creating a token from scratch. The difficulty of it would depend on the features you want your token to have only. To launch a BSC token, you need to install MetaMask wallet on your computer, which is available on metamask.io. After you download it, you need to install it in your browser and create a MetaMask wallet. If you already have one, you would need to import it. Next, you need to connect a Binance Smart Chain network to it. Binance has BEP2, Binance Exchange, and BAP20, Binance Smart Chain networks. BEP2 has an ability to transfer coins. BEP20 has an ability to run smart contracts. And in our case, we would need to have BNB on our BSC network. If you don't know how to do it, search for Binance Smart Chain MetaMask connection. Through the first link, you find mainnet and testnet information that you need to add to your MetaMask. Open MetaMask's settings, networks, add a new network, copy and paste the main network's information, press OK, and now you can see that we have a Binance Smart Chain network on our MetaMask. The same procedure works for a test network. You need to copy and paste all the information and add a new network. The difference between mainnet and test networks is on the test network you can play around with your code, test your contract before proceeding with the real one on mainnet, and if you did something wrong with the contract, you can always redo it. If you find the process difficult, there is another way of connecting your MetaMask with Binance Smart Chain, and it's through morales.io. Choose Speedy Nodes section, choose BSC network, and press on Endpoints button, then press on Mainnet Add to MetaMask button and Testnet Add to MetaMask button. As you can see, it works the same. We would need a MetaMask wallet in order to interact with the network and use it when we create our token and make transactions. Next, we would need to get some free BNB on BSC testnet into our wallet. For that, we need to go to testnet.binance.org/faucet-smart. Here we copy the account address and paste it into the website. Here I specify the amount of 1 BNB and press the button. So now we can see I have a new 1 BNB in my wallet. Since I had an initial 0.97 of BNB before, Now I have 1.97 of BNB on testnet. Next, you need some real BNB on your MetaMask wallet on Binance Smart Chain network. My MetaMask already has some BNB on it, but in case you don't know how to do it, you can go to Binance, buy some BNB, then go to wallets, fiat and spot, choose BNB, press withdraw, copy the address from your MetaMask, then choose Binance Smart Chain network, double check the network and address, specify the amount and proceed with the withdrawal. After you proceed, you will receive your BNB within 2 or 3 minutes. Also, don't forget that you will receive your BNB on BSC chain, so you can always select your network in MetaMask here. Next, we will start creating a token on BSC testnet. First, we would use a test network to test our token. Then we can spend some real money to create the same token on mainnet, where people would be able to see our token. There is a standard for tokens called ERC20. In our case, we will be using BEP20 token as it is a copy that uses the same method. We will be using Solidity smart contract language to create a Binance Smart Chain token. And the process is the same if we were creating it on Ethereum blockchain network. The huge number of tokens on the market can be explained by how easy it is to create one, thanks to templates. They are free and easy to use. All we need is to copy and paste. For example, there is OpenZipline that provides a very secure way of creating a token. It's been on the market for a while and lots of people use it. In our case, we will simplify the process even more. We would use Binance Smart Chain official template for token creation. We Google Binance Smart Chain token template, and on the first page, we find official docs of Binance. Here, we can download a simple template of BEP20 token. I will put the link in the description box below. After we download the template, we need to go to remix.ethereum.org website, which is the official tool for writing smart contracts for Ethereum and Binance Smart Chain. Here on the main page, we need to open contracts folder and create a new file by pressing on this button. We can name it BEP20TokenTest.sol. Next, we need to open that template which we downloaded. In case you don't know how to use it, you can use editors or a tool called Atom. After we open it, we would need to copy the code from it and paste it to the Remix's new file we have created. So this is a code which is provided by Binance itself and it is official. Next, we would need to find a field called constructor. Here we can see parameters which we can specify to set up our token. The name field is for your token's name. Let's name it test BEP20 token. When it is a text, you should put it into inverted commas. Next symbol is a ticker name of how you would like for your coin to be represented. For example, let's call it TBT. Also put it into inverted commas. Next, it would be decimals that you can specify. You can type 18, since Ethereum system has 18 decimal system. Total supply parameter specifies the amount of token you would like to create. If I would like to create 1 million tokens, I would need to write 1 million multiplied by 10, double multiplied by 18. So it will create 1 million of our TBT token. When we use numbers, we don't need to put them into inverted commas. Next, we would need to compile our code. If we have errors in it, it would give us a red notification. In case we didn't put our token name into the inverted commas, the computer would show an error. Okay, let's change it back. Press compile. Next, we can launch our token on a test network. Here, you can specify the environment. For example, JavaScript VM. It is basically a virtual machine that you can run and test your contract. Let's launch it on this virtual machine. So now our contract is launched and we successfully created our token. So as you can see, we create 1 million of tokens and here we can see that total supply. The total supply shows in way. You can check it by going to eth-converter.com and copy paste this amount to way. So as you can see, the amount we see is 1 million. Next, let's create it on our testnet. Delete your deployed contracts and choose another environment called injected Web3. Then change your MetaMask to testnet and press deploy button. Here you would need to spend your free test BNB. Also, you would need to specify your account, which is a MetaMask account. You would need to connect it. And then within 5 seconds, you would see that our token is successfully created on Binance testnet. Then you can copy your address, go to BSC testnet and search for your address. As you can see, we have a new contract creation. Here we can find our token testBAP20 token TBT with one holder and a total supply of 1 million TBT. You can also quickly search for your token information by copying the deployed contract number and pasting it into the testnet. So that's it, our token is ready. To see the token on your MetaMask, you would need to add its link. The token is already in your wallet. The only thing you would need to do is to tell MetaMask to show it to you. So just open MetaMask, press add token, and copy paste your token's address into the token contract address field. As you can see, it is automatically fetched the token symbol and token decimal. So press next, add tokens, and now your million tokens are shown in your MetaMask. Now we can actually send our tokens to other accounts just by copying another address, choosing our token, pressing send, specifying the amount of token you would like to send, pasting the address and pressing next and confirm. Make sure that every time you create or send your tokens, you spend the native currency of your network. Now, as you can see, you successfully transferred your token to another address. Next, we would need to deploy our token on BSC chain. We go through the same procedure, but choosing BSC network. So let's actually modify some parameters of our coin. Let's call it Booby coin. Set symbol as BBE and maximum supply of 50 million. Let's compile it, change the network and deploy it. Here we would spend some real BNB on it. And as you can see, we successfully created our token and we spent around $2.5. Yes, it's that easy. So now we have our token on Binance Smart Chain network. If you would like to create it on Ethereum network, you can follow the same procedure and deploy it on Ethereum. So that was the first way of executing a code by yourself and creating a token from the template we used. As we said earlier, there are different token generators on the market by using which you can generate your token easier. Only it will cost money. Usually it's around 0.7 to 5 BNB. The advantage of third-party tools is that they have different features which you would need to look for in templates if you do it yourselves. For example, it can allow for your token to burn, be deflationary, mint, be auto-redistributed or auto-unlocked, as well as other features. If you are interested in how to program it, leave a message in the comment section below. Of course, another way of creating your token is to find people who will write the code for you. Sometimes even for prices cheaper than those of third-party platforms. However, programmers can create backdoors in codes and take advantage of projects. So now, since you know how easy it is to create your token, in another video we will be talking about the next steps. What do you do after you create your token? How you can add your token to a decentralized exchange and set up initial liquidity for your token so that people can buy it? And also we will discuss how you can prepare yourself for an airdrop and market your token. So that was our video for today. Thank you very much for watching. If you found it useful, hit the like button and subscribe. I'm Vlad. See you in the next episode.